The Scythians were a group roaming the Eurasian steppe, whomst were dwelling horse nomadic warriors. Absolute goats. Who lived around the first millennium before Common Era. We'll be doing an analysis on the study of 111 samples from 39 archaeological sites. From many different Iron Age cultures, such as the Pisidic, Tasmola, Sako, Sargat, and medieval samples and antiquity samples. Study shows the importance of the transition from Bronze Age to Iron Age. The Scythians went through a transition where in the Bronze Age, they were sedentary to a nomadic cattle breeding lifestyle, showed an increase in warfare and advancements in military technology, and introducing hierarchical or elite-based societies. No longer egalitarian, I guess. Post-Iron Age, the Eurasian steppe became a place for Turkic empires and proto-Mongolic ones, like Xiongnu and Xianbei. In the east, of course, but from the south, we have Persian empires like the Kangyu or Sogdians. The transition from Iron Age and the Eurasian steppe was seen through the varying degree of extra East Eurasianness and more Neolithic Iranian-related ancestry and Mesolithic Caucasian hunter-gatherer. The findings of the genetic analysis suggest that this significant demographic shift occurred during the transition from Bronze Age to Iron Age in the Kazakh steppe. However, there are still homogeneous clusters of individuals belonging to the same cultural group or geographic area, specifically the individuals from the sites associated with the early Iron Age Tasmola culture and the published Saka culture of the central North Kazakhstan cluster, together in the middle of the plot, and this genetic profile persists in the later middle to late Iron Age. Using the QPAD-M calculator, we have the genetic modeling of Iron Age groups mentioned prior. The Scythian genetic makeup consisted of Khuvsgul plus Steppe, Middle Late Bronze Age, and Turan, i.e. ancient southern part of Central Asia. Sarmatians and later Tian Shan Sakas, these groups have their genetic roots in the Turan region, specifically the Turan Chalcolithic, BMAC, and post-BMAC groups. The Tasmola, Kargantus, and Pisidic samples show an additional amount of Eastern Eurasian genetic influx, which is interestingly is not sourced from the same Eastern proxies as the previous groups. Instead, it can be modeled with the Northeast Asian lineage represented by the early Neolithic groups from the Devil's Gate Cave, the site in the Russian Far East. Eastern Eurasian admixture skyrocketed post-Iron Age. It can be seen from the individuals from the Xianbei Han Barrel 300 Common Era sample, Karakaba 830 CE sample, and Kayalik 950 CE individual samples. In southern Kazakhstan, the Otirar Oasis, 3 out of 5 individuals from this region called Konirtebe Tobe 300 Common Era have a distinct genetic profile that is closer to the published Kangyu 250 Common Era individuals from a similar time period and region. What's more interesting is that one of these individuals, KNT005, carries a South Asian Y haplogroup and shows South Asian genetic component in their admixture, indicating a possible South Asian influence in the region. Another individual sample, KNT004, shows a shift towards East Asians in the PCA that you currently see. Studies suggest that around 10% of South Asian and 50% of East Eurasian influx can adequately explain these genetic profiles. Yeah, take a look.